Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome back to the new Super Mario Bros. Wii playthrough. In our last episode, we finished off World 3, and we have now moved on to World 4, which marks another transition and another change in scenery. We've gone from a frigid mountain range covered with snow to a tropical island bathed in sun, so I hope you guys brought some sunblock. Anyway, let's go ahead and get started with World 4-1. So the most obvious thing about World 4, as you can see right here, is that World 4 is basically the water world of this game. Almost every level in this world is going to have some type of water theme to it, with a couple of exceptions, but for the most part, this is the world where you're going to be doing a lot of swimming and you're going to be dealing with a lot of aquatic enemies and obstacles, which shouldn't be that bad. I mean, World 4 is a step up from World 3 with its different gimmicks and such, but still, this is a totally manageable world, at least the first half of it. Anyway, we have the penguin suit returning from World 3. Now, it may seem odd that there would be a penguin power-up in a tropical area, you know, since, you know, penguins typically live in cold areas, but this actually makes sense because in the real world, there are actually penguins that live in tropical climates. So, a tropical island area with a penguin power-up? Not so weird, actually. Also, having the penguin suit is extremely helpful when swimming around because, in real life, penguins are actually very good swimmers. Now, as you can see, one major enemy we're dealing with in this level is the urchin. The small urchins you can freeze to make them less of a threat, but these big urchins, you can't do anything to these guys. The only thing that will take out a big urchin is a Starman. You can't even freeze them, so we're simply going to ignore them and avoid them as best we can, and we can do that by using these Koopa Troopas as stepping stones. You're also going to need to use the penguin suit, as you have seen, to get most of the star coins. In fact, you're going to need the penguin suit for all of the star coins, because you have to freeze enemies to use them as platforms. Especially this area. I hate this area that we are approaching right now because of what you have to do to get the final star coin of the level. See if I can position myself. Okay, freeze this guy. Freeze this guy. Jump across them both very quickly, and you get the final star coin. So one world in, we are perfect with the star coins. That is a very good way to start. And freeze, mister. Gotcha. So yeah, let this be a preview of what to expect in World 4. You're going to be doing a lot of swimming, and some of the star coins are going to be a little bit more challenging to grab. Let's go ahead and pay a visit to Toad. We have a green Toad house, that means we have an opportunity for extra lives. I mean, I don't think I really need extra lives at this point. I've got 73, but you never know. Okay, ooh, we got a chance for a 2-up. Nice, let's see. Oh, I missed it. I mistimed it. I was going for at least one of the 2-ups, but I fired a little too early. Oh well. We got one. That's better than nothing. Then again, getting one extra life is better than nothing, like getting second place is better than getting third, but you know, we have one more extra life. We have one more extra life than we had before. Get your words right, Matt. Anyway, right off the bat, we already have a Mook battle, so let's go ahead and take care of it. Here we have the Porcupuffer from Super Mario World. For those of you who may not remember, Porcupuffer appeared in one of the Vanilla Dome stages. I want to say it was Vanilla Secret 2. It's the level that has the dolphins. And this guy in Super Mario World would chase you relentlessly through the stage. So now we actually have to deal with him in a Mook battle, but luckily he's pretty predictable. He will basically leap out of the water periodically, but he will go from one end of the map to the other, and he's actually very easy to avoid. No trouble at all. 3 extra mushrooms, that's very nice. And we have a fork in the road. We can either go to World 4-2 or World 4-3, since we're going in order. World 4-2 it is. Now this level brings back a gimmick that goes all the way back to the original Super Mario Brothers on the NES, and it is a very familiar gimmick, and it's a gimmick I really don't like. It is Cheep Cheeps leaping out of the water at you. Yes, they bring back this gimmick. And the best thing I can say is, once you have an opening to run across this level, basically you have to run through the whole level and make sure you don't get hit. And the best thing I can say is, once you start running through the level, don't stop. Like, if you get on one of those straightaways and you have to run, don't stop moving. Because if you stop moving, all you'll do is set yourself up to get hit by the Cheep Cheep as it leaps out of the water. Yep. And these guys go really high, but actually we have a star, man, so this is going to be very useful. Grab this star coin right here, and off we go. Anyone up for a fish fry? I sure could go for some fried fish, now that I think about it. Alright, this last one. Gotta actually make that platform drop so that you can drop down with it. And, no! Ooh! That was close, I almost fell too low. Yeah, when you're underwater, don't fall past the screen, because it will count as falling into a bottomless pit, and bottomless pits in Mario being death. But not today. Two levels down, still perfect for star coins. That's the way it should be. That opens the path to the fortress, but you know we're not done yet. Now it's time for World 4-3. And we're just going to keep going. Let's go ahead and get through this. Alright, time for another beach level, and this time we have crabs. Anyone up for some crab legs? I know I could go for some crab legs right now, but that's just me. I love crab legs. King Crab for the win. Anyone watch Deadliest Catch? Luckily, we don't have to go through quite as much crap as those guys do, so we actually have it easy compared to the Alaskan crab fishermen. For one thing, we don't have rough seas and whatnot to deal with. Seriously, the Bering Sea is not a place you want to be. It's not a very friendly place. But actually, I want to go back, because earlier I actually passed a block that contained a Starman. So let me see if I can go back and grab it. And off we go! Die, you big urchin! How do you like that? So yeah, that's what you can do to the big urchin. You can kill it with a Starman. That is the only thing that will kill it. Now, one thing I want to do now is I actually want to clear out all these enemies here, because we're going to need to use a different power-up to get the final star coin. You see that little pipe over there at the far right of the screen? We're going to need the mini mushroom to grab it, and to get the mini mushroom, simply go over here, and the power-up is yours, and now I have to adjust to Mario's jumping, because he jumps really high, and he hangs in the air when you do it, so you have to adjust to that! Ooh, I almost got intercepted by that rock. Sorry, folks, I got a little jumpy right there. And there's the final star coin of World 4-3, so now all we have to do is get to the end. And to do that, run on water! Yeah! How do you like that? I love being able to run on water like that. Just made that whole segment a joke. Hey, sea urchins, you can't get me. And... ah, not quite. So we're off to a great start here in World 4. We are perfect so far with the star coins, man. But now we get to a real challenge. Hopefully. Go ahead and give myself a regular mushroom. Gonna need to be Big Mario for this one because it is now time for the World 4 Fortress. So, off we go. And our Koopaling for this world is Wendy, so let's see what gimmick she has. Now, despite what I said earlier about most of the levels having a water gimmick, the World 4 Fortress is actually the exception, or one of the exceptions. We do not have to deal with any type of actual water in this stage. Instead, Wendy relies on a different gimmick. Wendy's fortress involves these conveyor belts that you will have to deal with, and there are also giant blocks that will fall into place and you have to avoid them or else you'll get crushed. And once again, in Mario, crushing means instant death. We don't want instant death. You know, as long as it's, you know, if it's happening to us, we don't want it to happen, but if we can instantly kill an enemy, yeah, we're okay with that. Also, you're going to have to use the big blocks as platforms to progress, so they're not just there as an obstacle, they're also platforms that you have to use to navigate. But really, overall, the World 4 Fortress really isn't that bad. I mean, you just have to be careful with the crushing objects and you'll be okay. This really isn't that bad. Star coin number 2. And checkpoint. Now, this the fortress here in World 4 actually does have a secret exit. However, I'm not going for it immediately. I'm going to go for the regular exit first, as always. And then I'll go for the secret exit. I know I've changed that around a couple times. I've gone for the secret exit first. But here, I am going to go for the regular exit first. And jump! Like, the only real thing about the falling blocks and whatnot is that you just simply have to time it. You have to watch the block carefully and make sure you time your run so that when you try to run past it, you don't accidentally end up, you know, running right as it drops. So it's all about timing, really, and just watching the pattern carefully to make sure that you don't mistime your run. Gonna become very important in this room. We have to try and get to that star coin before they all drop into place and we're not able to grab it. Oh, no! Ah, dang it. I was a little too slow. That's the first time we've died in a fortress. Luckily, we didn't lose that much progress. Like, I kinda hesitated to grab the coin, and that's what cost me. You know, I hesitated to grab the coin, and that allowed the block enough time to come down and crush me. I really should have been a little more aggressive trying to go for that. Because you have a very small window, you know, to grab that coin, so you really can't hesitate. If you're gonna go for the coin, go for it, you know? That's probably the best way to put it. I was hoping that would be a power-up. Alas, no. And go, 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 go. It would be one thing if I didn't have to fight the conveyor belt, you know? That's what makes it a little bit more daunting, is you have to worry about the conveyor belt because that is going to affect your movement, obviously. And go! Let's try this again. I swear it's really tempting to just dash for it right now, but that's... yeah. And got it! success. Also, it is actually this area where you can find the secret exit. However, you have to go through that wall on the left, but we've already blocked it off because of the falling blocks, so we can only go through the normal exit, which I was going to do anyway. And there doesn't seem to be any power-up for me to grab, so let's go ahead and do it. Wendy, I'm home! Alright, so what Wendy's gonna do here is Wendy's gonna launch this ring-shaped projectile, and this ring-shaped projectile is going to ricochet around the room. So not only do you have to keep track of Wendy's movements, you also have to keep track of the projectile! Oh my goodness, man. This is death-defying. Gotcha! Really not a challenge at all. Of course, we ain't done yet. Once again, we're only halfway done. Alright, so that opens up a new level, but we still have that secret exit. And once again, we have another toad to rescue, but once again, I'm not worrying about those for now. Going to go ahead and save, and now I'm going to go for the secret exit. So I'll see you guys back in the room that actually leads there. So, see you after the jump cut. Alright folks, we are back in the fortress, and now it is time to go for the secret exit, which can be either easy or difficult depending on how you approach it. You have to basically dash for it as soon as you reach that room, as soon as you come out of that warp pipe. Don't worry about anything else. Hold that dash button and run. That's the best way I can put it. Don't wait for any of the blocks to come down. Just go for it. And the secret exit from the fortress will actually lead to the cannon. So we have another opportunity to skip to a later world. We are obviously not going to do that. And we are going to save our progress for realsies. And I'd say that's a good place to stop. So that is a wrap on this episode of the new Super Mario Bros. Wii playthrough. We are halfway done with World 4, and the second half awaits us. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, be sure to like and leave a comment and tell me what you think. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.